or we go to general store, what basic difference we can see when it comes to mode of payment? Every other retailer do have phone pay, google pay, qr code, paytm likewise, and they don't even expect you people or their customers to make them payment by cash. There's no compulsion that any person who's buying something has to pay cash only. They can pay by scanning QR code or by phone pay or google pay by taking their numbers. So these all decision making processes based on the latest updates, technological changes, social changes, retailers in organized as well as unorganized sector do take. Now when it comes to retailing, there are two major portions, unorganized retail and organized retail. This basic is already made clear to you in previous session. Now when it comes to decision making process with reference to product, price, promotion and place, unorganized retailers, those who are running laundry shop, bakery, general store or certain types of stores like restaurant or tea stall, their location, their range of products or services what they are providing, promotion as such, they spend very little amount, and prices of those products depends on at what rate they are buying from wholesaler. Price as a factor is not much in control of any unorganized retail trader, because he himself, that retailer in and around our area, he himself is buying in smaller quantity compared to Big Bazaar, Shoppers Stop or DMart. So he cannot bargain with his wholesaler for lower rate. To the contrary, those all organized stores who are buying, let us assume Shoppers Stop or More Shoppee is keeping sugar for sale in 1 kg, 2 kg and 5 kg pack. Now when they are buying in bulk, that may be 1000 kg, that may be 5000 kg also, because More as a Shoppee within one city like Pune do have 10 branches. And for all those 10 branches, 10,000 kilo or what we say 10 ton is also very small quantity. As a retailer who's residing in our area, as a small retailer, unorganized retailer, 10,000 kg or 10 ton is too big quantity for that local retailer. So when it comes to buying product for organized retailer, that decision process also involves high level of bargaining. So these all things are part of retail management decision process. Now we are having concern and looking into decision process of retailers who are in organized sector only. We don't look into unorganized sector. Now here what happens, at first let's have one brief that retail managers need to know the environment in which they operate before they can develop and implement effective strategies. Where the store is located, what particular product in and around catchment area. Catchment area for any organized retail store is up to 1 kilometer to less than 1 kilometer. Means what? If any store is located at the heart of the city, from that store, circumference of 1 kilometer max to max can be measured, because within that circumference also, within that radius also, there could be one more, two more competing retailers available. So instead of coming to that particular store, they may go to nearby stores also, because what products retailer are keeping in organized store, one competing store is having the same products range with the other competing store also. So what happens here? Retail managers need to know the environment in which they operate before they can develop and implement effective strategies. The critical environmental factors in the world of retailing are macro environment and micro environment. We have seen earlier in basics of marketing, what is macro environment? Political, economic, social, technological, cultural, and legal environment is called as macro environment. Micro environment, what are the contents of micro environment? Internal organization, employees working within the organization, product range or services, what are being sold to the retailers. What all are the other micro environmental contents? Students, please answer. Size of the organization, initial investment done by the organization to start the venture or that particular company. These all are micro environmental factors which are under control of any, partly control of any organization. Now, competitors are important part of retail decision making. A retailer's primary competitors are other retailers that use the same type of store. This competition between same type of retailers is called as intra-type competition. When a retailer is selling food product that may be partly processed or fully processed food, the same particular brand of food or same content-wise food is sold in other 10 retail stores. That type of competition is called as intra-type competition. Now, when retailers offer merchandise or products not typically associated with their type of stores, such as clothing in drug store, the result is scrambled merchandising. What that retail store is meant for and what particular product they are selling, if their mixing is matching with each other, that is called as scrambled merchandising. Now, intertype competition. What intertype competition suggests us? It is present between retailers that sell similar product using different types of store. When it comes to discount store, that may have a XYZ brand. The same is also available in department store. That could be a food product, consumer durable, home appliances, or many other types of products having high, low prices. So this is what intertype competition. Now customers also, and in fact, customers are at the center when it comes to retail management decision-making process. To develop and implement an effective strategy, retailers must understand why customers shop, how they select a store, and how they select among that store's products. Now, what is stated here, let me read once again so that it would be easier for you to understand. To develop and implement an effective strategy, strategy making is very important decision process for any retailer. Retailers must understand why customers shop. When it comes to any customer, for what reason he is shopping. When they are shopping, what is the selection procedure for a store they took and how they select among the store's product. What type of product they buy, whether that is already planned or for sake of impulse buying, they are doing it. These all things are very much important when it comes to developing strategy. And these all things which are associated with customers' decision-making process of choosing a product and choosing a store are very important. Developing a retail strategy. Retail strategy indicates how the retailer plans to focus its resources to accomplish its objective. Now, very first thing when it comes to decision making is stated here is developing a retail strategy. And here, when it comes to retail strategy, retailer plans to focus its resources. I am not just going with explanation for PPT. Certain questions which are easy to answer and require your common sense. To be very frank, I have to ask you, when it comes to retailer who's planning to focus its resources, what all are the resources a retailer do have? What resources when it comes to an organized retail store like Big Bazaar, like Reliance Fresh, like Shopper Stop, what resources a retailer do have? Yes, please. You heard my question? Students, are you there?
Yes, sir, we are there.
Then what all are the resources a retailer have to plan? What resources meant by here?
So the products which are for the sale.
Okay, all types of merchandise which he is in plan to sell. That may be food category or consumer durables, electronics and electrics, or that may be a retail outlet for two-wheelers or company outlet, franchisee, whatever mode of retail store it may be. But very important thing, just like soul in human body, what it is? Products what a retailer is in plan to sell. Apart from product as resource, what else he is having?
Good customers.
Resources of retailer is not customers. Please don't have this misunderstanding. Resources are used to convince customer to buy product. Apart from product, location where he is having his store, infrastructure, what he is using, technical help, what he is taking for IT or technical team, what he is working, who's working with him, and his own employee from floor assistant for a customer up to branch manager of that retail store. Investment in money, what he is making to develop that store. These all things, warehouse, a retail store, by look, we visit only the point where actual product is kept for sale. Apart from products which are kept on rack in a presentable manner, the same product in bulk quantity, he requires to store. And that storage is done in a warehouse, godown. Also, that belongs to him, so that from that warehouse, quickly he can bring it in the actual selling point of purchase. So these all things are resources for a retailer. 24/7 water supply, 24/7 electric supply. These are very much necessary things for a retailer, so that he can serve his customer for longer duration. Instead of 8 hours or 10 hours, he can serve for 12 hours to early morning to late night in two shifts also. Without electric supply or in discontinuous phase of electric supply, he should have generator. Uninterrupted power supply is very much demanding thing as a resource for any retail store. And all these things, when it comes to resources, he should be ready with them. Otherwise, what happens? In late evening at 7:30 in the evening, if a retailer experiences power cut, everywhere it is dark, there may be chance of shoplifting. People will take undue advantage of that power cut. No one will come to know who came inside the store and who went out. And in such situation, customers will feel high level of inconvenience to buy a particular product. They can't see it, they can't touch it, they can't smell it. So these type of resources are very much important when it comes to developing a retail strategy. And even in such situation, if state board power supply is getting discontinued frequently or unpredictably, in such situation, alternate arrangement of power supply should be made by him so that his customers will not have any inconvenience. Even if they had, it is for a while, just for sake of 1 minute. And there shouldn't be any shoplifting. Now, many giant size stores do have hidden cameras. These days, they have CCTV everywhere. But even because of large size departments and the walk-in customers every day are 20,000-25,000. So in such situation, they are looking at CCTV kept at one location and movement of all customers to avoid shoplifting. Now what happens if a protein supplement comes at 650 rupees and that particular retailer is having 150 rupees profit margin? When he is buying at 500 rupees, he is selling at 650 rupees. What happens if one powder of protein supply, one tin, is getting stolen? Someone took it, kept in his pocket or kept somewhere hidden and went out. You know how much loss he suffered? It's not 150 rupees. It is 650 rupees. And that way, he has to sell another four tins, so that four or five tins, so that he can come to break even for that particular tin. Shoplifting in Indian continent is huge one. People come in, buy nothing, just look at the product with the size, with the shape they are. If they are in small size, for them it is easier to shoplift. And in such situation, RFID likes technology. What is meant by RFID? Any idea you have? We are talking of resources for retailer. RFID is a technology where radio frequency identification device is assembled with the product which is been bought by customers. And they are passing through a specific door. That door also is having RFID assembly. If the bill is not been made or the product is not been purchased, then that will make a beep sound, which will indicate that the product or the unit is stolen by that individual customer. So these all factors are resources for a retail strategy. When organized retailers are working together as a team, they do have to think of many things at a time. It's not just selling product and having margin. Apart from resources, what else is explained here? The target market or markets towards which the retailer will direct its efforts. The nature of the merchandise and services the retailer will offer to satisfy the needs of the target market. STP, segmentation, targeting, and positioning are very important decision-making processes for a retailer and retail strategy, and how the retailer will build a long-term advantage over its competitors. Segmentation is done based on geographic, demographic, psychographic, and behavioral. Yesterday also I have told you. Strategic decision areas. Definition of its market. Now, definition here is not as a scientific one or academic. What is meant by defining a market? that market, if it belongs to urban area, semi-urban area, or rural area. If that particular market do have upper middle class in large quantity, middle class in large quantity, or lower middle class in large quantity. Population, dense, medium, or rare. People educated, literate, or uneducated. These all things are relevant with definition of its market. Which product you are in plan to sell and which are the people, which location or which area you people as a retailer are selling. Or based on population, which particular product you are in plan to buy and to sell for retail customers. This is what relevant to definition of its market. Financial status. Now, financial status of a retailer plays an important role. How much investment initially he is making? It's a big bang opening for that particular retailer throughout India, throughout one zone, or for few selected metro cities, or that particular retailer is working for a specialty segment and he is operating in chain stores. That way, his financial status plays an important role. Location, this particular factor is very, very important. Why? Because once a location selected and a store started working out, if retailer realizes that the location chosen by him is not giving proper response, and within that same area, if he would have selected other location, he would have been in benefit. He cannot go for. Once you select a location, built up your retail store, or adopt for or rented giant size, medium size, small size store, getting removed from that particular place or stopping operations at that particular place and choosing another one is very costly affair. Selection of store location plays very strategic and important decision. You must have seen most of the hardware stores where automobile spares, then building material, construction material, all these things are available. These all hardware stores are available in which location of city? When it comes to location for any hardware store, owner of the hardware store prefer to go for which location? Please let me know. You got my question?
No, sir. Can you please repeat it?
When it comes to location, to decide which location to start a retail store in organized sector or unorganized sector, I am quoting example of hardware store. Now, hardware stores, what they do have? They have spare parts. They have building and construction material. They have household and family usage products like floor cleaner, bathroom fittings. All these things are sold in hardware stores, isn't it? When a retailer is about to start a hardware store, which location of any city like Pune, Kolhapur, Sangli, Satara, which location of city, I mean to say only city, not out of these four, which location of city she will prefer to go for?
Urban location.
City itself is in urban area, my dear friend.
So where the construction sites are going to be started or on the verge of starting, or where they are going?
Construction sites are most of the time these days are located in suburban areas. Now, when construction sites are buying material, they don't buy on daily basis. The promoter and builder are quite shrewd. They buy in bulk quantity. Now, when it comes to hardware stores, most of the time, hardware stores are located at the heart of the city, nearby central bus stand, central railway station, or the crowded places where maximum people do come every day. Once in a week, if market is there, that market where it is located, that particular place, most of the hardware stores will be there. Location as a policy or as a strategy is a very serious one. If a retailer is making mistake in selection of location, he is going through big loss that is difficult to recover. Now you see any multi-speciality hospital, this what we say, X-ray, then CT scan, then pathology laboratory, and very important, medical store. Most of the medical stores for a multi-speciality hospital are within that building only. Although if they are not in that building, in and around you will find another 3-4 medical stores, because location plays very important role. When a patient is getting treated by a doctor, that may be MD medicine, MS surgeon, orthopedic, gynecologist, pediatric, whatever specialization he may be, once the doctor consults that patient and patient comes out with prescription paper in his hand, what he is doing, he is searching for nearby medical store. And these medical stores have location chosen wisely. Most of the medical stores are always located in and around hospitals where doctors are practicing in full swing. Unlike hardware stores, heart of the city is not proper location for any medical store. Now what happens, just because a surgeon is doing well practice, a medical store nearby his clinic or nearby his hospital, you will find is keeping specific category of medicines required for surgery most of the time. Other medicines they are keeping in optimum quantity. But maximum quantity of surgical medicines are kept there, because the doctor who's practicing that near that location is a surgeon. So choosing location, you will find a pawn shop near a restaurant. They are acting like a parasite. Why? Because a restaurant of 20-25 chairs, even 60-100 chairs, and doing good in their business, the moment customers come out of their restaurant, they go for that small pawn shop. Every other restaurant do have pawn shop outside that restaurant. All tobacco products are sold there. You must have seen it. So these all things are relevant with location. Organizational and human resource structure. Now, organizational structure will have a branch manager. Branch manager will report to middle, higher authorities or partners of that organized retail store. And within one branch, there will be floor-wise allocated employees, floor assistant, cashier, housekeeping, security, and a person who looks after repair and maintenance of equipments allocated inside that retail store. This is what relevant to human resource structure. Information systems. This information systems is very much important, because one particular product, 100 units may be available. Within Colgate, there are 12 different brands, and within those 12 different brands, there are 50 gram, 100 gram, 250 gram, or 150 gram different sizes. So information required to be kept about the product availability and its total count is very important thing. So this is how information system works out. Again, those who are regularly visiting that particular store, those customers' contact ID or phone number should be there with them, and such customers' data is required to be kept with them so that specific discount, special discount allowance could be given to them. This is how information system works. Supply chain organization. Whatever product is needed to be made available by wholesaler, stockist, agent, distributor, that should come in time for retail store. I have yesterday given one example. Even if you go to the remote location of India, where hardly 300 to 500 people are residing in a village, you will be having one retailer operating and serving that limited population. That retailer may not have Pepsi, Coke or Thumbs Up, but he is keeping, carrying, selling Parle G biscuits. This is the effectiveness or efficacy of supply chain organization. Who all are supplying you product of which category in how much quantity? It's quite possible. There are two types of supply chain challenges. One supplier is forcing you to keep more product. In fact, they are not much selling. The other supplier, you have to repeatedly ask him to do in-time supply so that whatever product in high demand will not have short supply, unavailability. So this is how supply chain organization plays important role in strategic decision areas. Customer relationship. Whichever customers are visiting your retail store, how well you welcome them? What is your communication with them? Are they left alone throughout the entire premises of retail store, or floor retail sales executives are helping them? See, these floor sales executives, they shouldn't be behind that customer every now and then. What happens? Certain customers do not speak anything or don't complain, but they are the most dangerous one. They feel uncomfortable. They want space. They want at their own to look after every product. Perhaps out of 10 seen product, they are buying one or two. But whenever they are taking out one particular product in their hand, looking at it, looking up about the size, shape, color of the product, usage or utility value, they are thinking at their own. A floor assistant shouldn't come and start quickly describing importance of that product, usage of that product, price of that product. No, they want calm. They want everything to happen peacefully. So customer relationships plays an important role, and existing customer require less cost of advertising. For potential customer, a retailer has to spend lots and lots of money in advertising. So customer relationship plays an important role. Retail mix strategy. Retail mix, what is retail mix? It's a set of decisions retailers make to satisfy customer needs and influence their purchase decision. Retail mix is a set of decisions retailers make to satisfy customer needs and influence their purchase decisions. Elements in the retail mix include types of products and services offered, product pricing, advertising and promotional programs, store design, product display, assistance to customers provided by salespeople, and convenience of the store's location. Within this second paragraph, everything is explained. Now, what is retail mix includes? Which type of product a retailer is selling? Now, Sony used to have very popular brand of LCD. Anyone can quote it? Sony world known company used to sell a very popular brand of LCD. Any idea you can give?
Bravia.
Yeah, and that one is the first LCD which was made available by Sony in the market when color television sets were selling very high. Although it took sizable time for Sony to establish, because customers' perception was compared to color TV set, LCD must be very costly. LCD as a product was not much accepted, but these days people prefer LCD LED to that of color TV set, because size of LCD screen is much higher or much more than that of a color TV set, and color TV set acquires too much space. These days houses in urban area are too small and they don't want their television set to occupy larger space in the house, mostly in the hall of the flat or house, what we can say. So this particular brand of Sony was sold by retail outlets. Franchisee were given to retailers, and their LCD were available from 17,500 rupees, the smallest one, up to 3,50,000 rupees in the retail store. Now it's quite possible that a person is buying around 1,25,000 rupees LCD of Sony. He comes early in the morning and leaves afternoon, late afternoon. Why? Because knowing technology of LCD, how to operate it, how to use it, how to install it, how to take care of it from dust, scratches, and other things, how comfortable it is compared to that of television, color television set. What more advantages LCD do have than that of a color TV? These all things are required to be explained by retailer, a technical person, team of Sony's technical division has to come and give installation to that customer, because color television set in a box, we can bring it on two-wheeler and we can install it as it is, where it is. But LCD requires certain fixing material, supporting stand, and its wiring is different also than that of color television. So these all things, along with product and services offered, plays important role in retail mix. Now, by continuing the same example of LCD pricing, a retailer of Sony outlet, retail outlet of Sony or franchise of Sony can explain him price of LCD compared to that of color television is almost similar. Even if it is few hundred rupees more, the technology what is used in LCD television is much higher than that of color television. Advertising and promotional programs. People do watch advertises most of the time and having impact on their back of the mind, just because audiovisual advertising, which is shown on television, commercials, between serials, between cricket match, between movie and any other time. And those advertisers do have impact on their mind. Image of a company, Sony do have very positive image for their customers. Then store design, where the store is located and how well they are designed. With the reference to this LCD, I would like to share one example here. When personally I went to see how well a LCD can operate, a retail outlet of different type of LCDs, different companies, Samsung, then Sony, Philips, all they were kept together, and that's two of different sizes, different prices. What was that retail store salesperson was doing there? He was having bunch of keys with him, and he thrown with full force on screen of that LCD. Even then, there were no scratches on the LCD screen. So this is how store design, merchandise display plays an impression, negative or positive, either way. Assistance to customer provided by salespeople and convenience of the store's location. The store should be at the rate of 1 or 2 kilometers from your residence. Even if it is 5 kilometers, if you are having your own vehicle, it's okay. More than that, customers don't care, even if it is very big size store. Ethical and legal considerations in a retail store. Ethics are the principles governing individuals and companies that establish appropriate behavior and indicate what is right and wrong. When you view your firm's policies or request as improper, you have 3 choices. Which are they? Ignore your personal values and do what your company asks you to do. Take a stand and tell your employer what you think. Refuse to compromise your principles. These are things. What it is stated here, ethics are the principles governing individuals and companies that establish appropriate behavior and indicate what is right and wrong. Ethics from company side, and as an individual, you may have your own ethics also. Now, certain retailers do not allow their customers to buy in the evening time once they switch on the lights. During evening time, no credit. Even if you are coming early morning next day, they will allow you to buy on credit. But late evening, they won't allow anybody to buy on credit. There will be one day out of a week. That day, they will keep the shop closed with the decision of association or that locality. And that day, even if a customer is coming to buy in huge amount, you have to ask him to come next day, next working day. This particular policy is ethics for a retailer. Now, when you view your firm's policies or request as improper, you have 3 choices. If your company's policies are improper, what as a retailer you have? Ignore your personal value and do what your companies ask you to. It's quite possible that companies are selling at very high profit margin, where you think this much profit margin shouldn't be charged from our innocent customers, as other marketers of the same category product are charging too less, why we are charging higher. And in such situation, if your ethics are not permitting you, what choices you have? Ignore your own opinion. What if it is high price? You have to sell it the way company want you to. Second thing, take a stand and tell your employer what you think. We have to communicate that the price for this certain product is too high and selling it is becoming difficult. And in such situation, we request you to lower the price. This is what we can communicate as a retailer. Refuse to compromise to your principle. Refuse to compromise your principles. Now, in such situation, you don't have to buy that particular product from that wholesaler. So this is how we can think of checklist for making ethical decisions. What all are the things we have to take into consideration while making ethical decisions? Would I be embarrassed if a customer found out about this behavior? Would my supervisor disapprove of this behavior? Would most coworkers feel that this behavior is unusual? Am I about to do this because I think I can get away with it? This is the checklist for ethical decisions. Would I be upset if a company did this to me? Would my family or friends think less of me if I told them about engaging in this activity, an illegal or unethical activity? Am I concerned about the possible consequences of this behavior? What possible consequences of a behavior can be if any retailer is doing black marketing, keeping his shop half closed, half open on a holiday or weekly off, or in these days situation is how critical you all know. Most of the shops are closed except medical store and food stores or milk store. Now there are many retailers who keep the shop closed outside. By appearance it looks like closed, but local people of that area just knock twice or thrice. He is keeping open the shutter half. Whatever is required, he is selling them, and again he is putting down shutter. So this is unethical practice. If government is asking you to keep your shops closed, you have to. Otherwise, what is happening? Corona as a communicable disease is spreading faster. When one retail store of any material it is selling open these days in urban area, at least 10-15 customers gather there. And what happens? They are not maintaining social distance. Out of 10, at least 3 will not have masks. And that way they are spreading this communicable disease, COVID-19. Who's responsible for this? That retailer who was keeping open this retail store. So this is unethical decision. Now, would I be upset if this behavior or activity was publicized in a newspaper article? These days, news about corona, number of patients died, number of patients recovered, number of patients found positive, everywhere it is there. But certain districts like Dhule, Bid, they have shown that around 250 retailers were sealed for next 1 week. Why? Because they kept their shop open in spite of collector's order. And this was shown on news TV channels. What happens? They get defamed. Their name is getting deteriorated. And such things are not working well on credibility issue. So this is hot relevant to ethical decisions. Would society be worse off if everyone engage in this behavior or activity? So this is what relevant to checklist of making ethical decisions. Now, one example here, how a retail store can work out for you. Being student of MBA, and you people are working, maximum of you are working elsewhere. What is the opportunity in career for organized retail sales? Most of the floor employees working in retail sector are plus two or max to max graduates. Their duties are aligned with shift. And being salespeople, they are getting optimum salary as basic one, but incentives more. And in such situation, what as a career choice an individual will have when he is completing his MBA in marketing specialization within India and Maharashtra, deemed to be university like T.Y. Patil in Mumbai, do have retail management as specialization for third and fourth semester. And if you are completing your specialized retail management course, there are lots and lots of chances for your career in stores like Shopper Stop, Big Bazaar, D-Mart, and likewise, there are many stores where you can start from middle management. And in such situation, where at international level, Dubai Mall, like in Dubai, or Walmart in US, Carrefour. In these type of stores, you also can get opportunity to work. Now, management opportunities in retail trade section are to cope with a highly competitive and challenging environment. Retailers hire and promote people with a wide range of skills and interests. Retailers employ people with expertise and interest in finance, accounting, human resource management, supply chain management, and computer systems, as well as marketing. These all are specialization. What we have in MBA, finance we have, human resource management we have, supply chain management, and system specialization also we have. So these all are opportunities for any young graduate who completes MBA, either in HR, finance, marketing, or IT system. Now, retail management is also financially rewarding career. Starting salaries are typically between $35,000 to $55,000 abroad. This figure in dollar is meant for USA. For college graduate entering management trainee position, those who completed their summer internship in retail sector and who are about to complete their MBA, it is always advisable to them, instead of looking into some other sector, as you have completed your summer internship of 45 to 50 days in retail sales, it's better you go for retail as a career sector. It's my experience, not I have worked in retail, but at Bangalore, there's one big branch of Shoppers Stop at Banerghatta Road. And they have huge variety in garment stores only. That three floored store is as good as one cricket ground. And when you visit that particular place in specific months of year, like April, May, or June, you will find definitely one MBA student, one or the other from different colleges, who are doing their summer internship and assisting you, getting introduced to them. You will come to know that they belong to certain popular colleges who are offering MBA in retail management specialization. And they are going on right track, doing their internship in retail institute like Shoppers Stop. So this is what relevant to management opportunities, entrepreneurial opportunities. In this lockdown, again and again, we are coming to the subject lockdown, because reality, what is known to us, last 1 year, most of the big giant sized industries are facing difficulties to operate, on account of short supply of raw material, on account of transportation closed down, on account of pandemic spread, or these all things. But what is available to us? All the salaried employees are sitting idle at their homes, having loss of job, getting indebted, not being able to repay their EMIs, home loan, personal loan, vehicle loan, whatever it may be. Who's working well? At the most, having optimum profit, most of the medical stores, retail stores, most of the retail outlets who are selling basic needed items, they are having huge crowd, because for them, allowed for limited hours, morning 7 to 11. Even then, in those 4 hours, they are doing business as good as one whole day. So, entrepreneurial opportunities, wherein your investment initially will be for buying or leasing a rented space, maybe 180 square feet, 250 square feet, based on your initial investment. And based on that investment, you can start your own, be your own boss, instead of reporting or getting stuck up with 9-to-5 job and in limited income. Do not hesitate, because you are highly educated. I know, or it's my personal experience, last 18 years I am working as a salaried employee. You won't be getting much than you expect. So this is how entrepreneurial opportunities are available when it comes to retailing. Retailing also provides opportunities for people who wish to start their own business. Some of the world's richest people are retailing entrepreneurs. Here, Jeff Bezos, you must be heard this name, of Amazon.com. There's a news that in the end of June 2021, he is resigning from Amazon.com. Now, after his research uncovered that internet usage was growing at the rate of 2,300% annually, means every month 100%. If 1 lakh users in month of January are using online trading internet, month of February, the total went up to 2 lakh, from 1 lakh to 2 lakh, from 1 lakh at the end of year, 23 lakh. And Bezos, the 30-year-old son of a Cuban refugee, quit his job on Wall Street. Wall Street is giving very attractive jobs, and left behind a hefty bonus to start an internet business. Jeff Bezos of Amazon.com is named after the river that carries the greatest amount of water, symbolizing his objective of achieving the greatest volume of internet sales. Now, Jeff Bezos overtook our Mukesh Ambani to become world's richest person. Hope you are known to this fact. Now, it is now the largest online retailer with annual sales over 20 billion, three times more sales than the second largest online retailer, Amazon.com, Flipkart. Then there are many other online retailers also available. So this is how Jeff Bezos convinced his capability and became the largest online retailer. So these all things are relevant with management decisions taken, and we will look into advancement in retail sales, which is like a digital era, online trading and all these things. So now I will stop. It's almost 7 o'clock, and next Saturday, please remember, we will be available between 7 to 8. Okay, thank you. Bye for hearing me.